Hello, this is the LEGO City Fun at the Beach set, which is a direct follow-on to the very well-received Fun at the Park People Pack from 2016. This comes with 15 different minifigures, so of course in this video I'm going to focus mostly on those. However, as you can see, there is a bunch of other stuff as well, so let me get some of that out of the way first. For starters, how about this sailboard? LEGO has done quite a number of these over the years, and I think that this is another good addition to the variety that they've created over time. Just a different printing on the vinyl piece itself. They actually give you a spare of those in the set. It's always nice, just in case one gets crinkled up in transport. And the base of this, the board itself, is just done in a solid lime green. Here's a hammock that is strung low between a couple of small palm trees, although I think maybe those could be fake palm trees that are just placed there to kind of fit into the look of the place, but they don't actually require maintenance. Just an idea. How about this reclining lounge chair and umbrella stand and old retro tape deck that's done in light bluish gray, or a sandcastle? These are all very appropriate things to have in a seaside scene. On the right is a small but nicely proportioned kind of personal one-on-one beach volleyball net for a little bit of fun there, and they include the volleyball piece as well. The lifeguard is up on a lifeguard station post, which is elevated well, makes good use of a limited number of parts, but there's no easy way to get up there for the figure, so I guess that guy needs to know a little bit of parkour to climb up on his own. And then down here, this weird looking thing, which almost looks like it's trying to be one of the robots from Mystery Science Theater, is actually supposed to be, I believe, a snow cone or shaved ice vending machine. Could be for soft serve, but I think that's what it's supposed to be. I think it's supposed to be for shaved ice. And then there's also a garbage can so that people can put their refuse in it. This new kayak is nice. I like how many connection points that it has on the top of it for custom building or turning it into something else, turn it into a small sailboat or something, or add some railing, kind of change the styling a bit. I'm especially impressed by the use of strictly hollow studs, which makes it even easier to attach more things to it. And they have this Technic axle hole back here, which goes all the way through the entire thing, which gives you even more options. It has a 2x3 stud floor in the thing. I'll show you the figure separately in a couple minutes. 2x3 floor with the studs on it, and there's also a pair of Technic's pin-sized holes in the base of that. More options for attaching it to things and things to it. Yeah, just lots of good stuff done with this. It'll actually float a little bit in the water. You can make it sink, but you can see it actually traps air underneath here, and I've tried it out. It actually will float and doesn't sink, even though it does have the holes there. All right, let's look at some of these figures in no particular order. The guy on the far left has dual molded legs with the regular blue, that's not a dark azure, just a plain blue, and the yellow down below. The chest print for him is relatively nondescript. It's not too ridiculously over the top muscled up, so it makes him look a little bit more normal than some of the shirtless figures that they've done before. He's got a confident, almost cocky kind of smirk on, though, to kind of offset that just a little bit. His hair is in medium nougat, or medium dark flesh. The kid, who's the second one in line, has triple molded legs with dark red going to yellow, back to dark red to represent shorts, and a little bit of skin of legs showing up, and then the shoes that he has on below that. And he's got a basketball team jersey on, a fan jersey, so that's pretty cool. The old lady has a very old style, a very modest swimsuit on, which is inspired by something probably from the 1920s or so. And then the guy on the far right, well, he's just helping to keep the place clean. He's just a custodial engineer for this beachfront area, which is actually really important. You want to have the place nice and clean for all of your figures to enjoy it. Just a little bit of print on for the shoulder blades for the guy on the far left, and there you can see how the things are molded, including the dual molded legs for the older lady, and a really good print on the back of that number 39 jersey for the kid. Here, the woman on the far left has a wetsuit on beneath her standard yellow life jacket, and I'll take that life jacket off in a minute so you can see the print there. This is a cool print for the hoodie for the boy. It's lime green color with a little bit of just regular green used for some shading for some elements. That's pretty nice, and he's got the standard, or fairly standard by now, medium azure colored smartphone or music, formerly could have been a music player app or device, but nowadays mostly they're just regular phones. This girl here, I think, has absolutely nothing new on her. I think that's all just reused parts and prints and such just put together here, which is fine. I don't think everything needs to be new in a set like this, and I think that she fits into this scene perfectly well. The older guy on the right with the metal detector, he is really cool. He's got a very nice Hawaiian shirt that's unbuttoned completely, but what I like about his Hawaiian shirt is that it's kind of subtle. It's got the dark azure color overall, and it's not too loud and crazy like some of the ones that are mostly made for tourists. It almost looks more like something that would really be worn by someone who actually lives in the tropics or lives in the Pacific Islands long term. So he may actually have retired out to wherever this scene is set. And I like the gentle smile on his face as well. He just looks so happy and peaceful in life in general. That just makes me happy to think that there's a minifig that's happy. Good print on the back of that torso as well. You see the hood for the kid with the lime green hoodie, so that's shown through nicely with the print on the back. Very crisp with its printing. And let me take some stuff off from the lady on the left. I actually really like the printing on the back of her wetsuit. I like that medium azure color that's going around the outside of it. It's a nice color and it's nicely formed. I've also taken the hair pieces off so that you can see the rest of the prints more easily. If I don't take off a hair piece and you don't see me showing you an alternate face for a figure, it's because there is no alternate face on that figure. So I don't think I'm actually missing anything. And with that life jacket removed on the left also, you can see how that kind of cyan color shows through on the front. It's a really nice color, even though it is just a wetsuit, and Lego has done so many wetsuits before that are based on a black base color. I really like that one, and I also like the metallic outlining that they put on it for the stitching. Here on the far left, we have a lifeguard who's actually wearing a shirt. That's nice to see for a change, and that's a good print that's useful for a number of different things, like, you know, PE instructors or possibly coaches for various sports. A really nice piece to add in as a new print. Has a slight little bit of metallic silver print for the whistle as well, and this is one that just invites changing out the arms as well. Of course, you want to be careful if you change the arms on Lego minifigures, because that can reduce the clutch power, the friction on those shoulder joints. You don't want to do it too many times. You want to do it with care, but it is something that can be done, and I could easily see that being done to change up the look of that figure or to use it in different contexts with that torso. Next up is a lady who looks like she could fit into a lifeguard crew as well. Got that kind of probably Baywatch original TV show inspired one piece red swimsuit. Not opaque enough with the printing of the skin color on that torso, especially in this large area just beneath the neck. That definitely needed to be a heavier application of that color to fit in a little bit better. But if you look at that from a distance, you don't look at it up this closely, it's not quite as noticeable. Actually, it's definitely not as noticeable just a few feet back. You have to pay a little bit more attention to it. Scuba diver is a good one to include in here. You have somebody who's doing something a little bit farther offshore. I do not believe he has any new print there. Let me take his helmet off with the snorkel on it as well, so you can see how bright and happy and cheerful his smile is. And then the girl on the right has a great new print for her top. It's just great. That is an instant classic, in my personal opinion. It would fit, almost perfectly fit into any sort of minifig context going all the way back to the beginning of minifigs in 1978. And yet it works just fine today. It looks like green apples are being represented with the pattern on that. She also has triple molded legs with the bright green, not regular green, bright green color. and yellow going back to bright green. Just really nice to see. I like her hairpiece as well. It fits with her quite well. All of these have good prints on the back. Every single one of them. I guess the lifeguard does have a kind of lifeguard specific print on the back of that torso, which in some scenarios might be seen as limiting for what else you can do with it, but it's not too obvious. I still think that that's a useful and a reusable torso. This shows you just a little bit more of the print for the girl, and nobody else has alternate faces. Here are a couple more retro sea or seaside inspired outfits with the probably 1940s era style of bikini top for the lady on the left. It's a nice looking print though. And the modest shorts with the dual molded legs from just regular green to regular yellow. Meanwhile, the woman on the right has kind of an early sailor, like a between turn of the century and 1920s, I'd say, inspired top with the stripes in dark azure, I believe that is, and white. I think that one could have been done as a gender neutral torso, but I'm okay with it. This has nice shaping to it. It's not too extreme, and I think it stands out in a good way. And she's got the ice cream cone there, or could be just a snow cone. I think that these are well outfitted, both of them, and they have very good prints, appropriate prints on the back. I definitely like the one on the left better. There's just more to it, more detail, but the one on the right continues around and has that just that little bit of red that continues from the kind of scarf or neckerchief, I think, that she's wearing. Last up, here's the kayaker, and I've given him the full frame so that you can see the entire oar set that he has all assembled together, just relative to his proportions. Those are just new parts at the ends there that can be removed. They just attach onto the end of anything bar-like, which is perfect. You can actually rotate these. They can surely be used to create custom propellers and things. Really great new part to add to the Lego parts inventory. And of course, I'm gonna have to take the life jacket off this guy. He has a very now familiar style on the back of his wetsuit. The front of his wetsuit, though, is fairly plain to me. More plain than most of them are. Almost looks a little bit old in that sense, like it might be from the late 90s or something. You can't win them all. Not everything needs to be super detailed, but just in my opinion, that one's a little bit down on detail on the front, though the back is good. Here's a dolphin in a plain medium blue, which I was certain was the same one that they used for the Lego Friends line, just with a different print for the eye to change the style to make it more compatible with minifigs rather than mini dolls. But it's not. It's a completely new mold. It's actually larger than the Friends one, has a different shape for the mouth, better defined, and it doesn't have the hole in the top for mini doll accessories like bows and such. It also has a different style on the underside. The only thing that I found to be not so great about this Friends design is that it was a little bit down on clutch power for that single attachment point underneath the body. You could always attach it from the tail, but under the body, that wasn't quite so good. The new one is definitely better at that. Basically has the same thing as the underside of a brick. A little bit better because you can jump with it. You can put even a non-hollow stud in the center there, but otherwise it's functionally the same. And that really surprises me that they went through the trouble of making an entirely new mold so quickly of something that's so similar. I suggest that there's a little bit of an embarrassment, a little embarrassing story inside of Lego behind this that they will be happy to put behind them. But for all intents and purposes, it's practically the same thing, just a little bit better. Of course, the clear stand here is not included. It's just being used by me for display. Here's a parrot in the classic red and green dual molded color scheme. The lobster was first introduced for the Lego Batman movie, and I love it entirely too much, and I will never be able to get too many of these because I just think it's so flippin' awesome. Has a single anti-stud on the base of it, and it looks really cool to me. I only wish they had included one more of these in this set so that you'd be able to get more than one at one time. Lastly, here's a dog, presumably trying to represent a Dalmatian, even though it's just the regular shepherd style of body. A silverfish, excuse me, a silver fish, not a silverfish, right? And then a banana, because that goes with the others, right? The highlights of this set for me are the kayak and the oar or paddle end pieces. These two female torsos with the green in them, of course, the lobster, and this guy, especially his very nice Hawaiian shirt there. Oh yeah, forgot, he's going treasure hunting, and they do include in the set one little pearl gold tile piece for him to find a nice little bit of treasure out on the beach. Let me know what your favorite things are from what you've seen here. I don't think that this is going to be as well received by the public as last year's set, as the Fun in the Park set, because that one was just really, really nice, introduced some really, really nice new things. But I think that this is very worthy of the line. I look forward to seeing if they make yet another thing like this in the future. I like the presentation. I like the fact that they are suggesting right on the box that you mix and match things. It's really not just a people pack, but a people parts pack. So I look forward to hearing what you think and what you like and what you don't like here. And I'll be talking to you again soon, because I'm going to get to work on my next video.